I use a MacBook Pro with an Android phone, a Google Pixel to be exact. And though out of the box, these two products are not really designed to work together, with the right mix of apps and tinkering and settings, you can definitely make these two products work well together. We'll break this down into 9 different sections. We'll look at file and clipboard sharing, tasks, calendar, notes, messaging, photos, web browsing, webcam, and mobile hotspot. And to be clear, this video is not in any way sponsored by anyone. The apps mentioned are my honest recommendations. Most of them are what I currently use. By default, these two products use two completely incompatible local file sharing protocols. The MacBook uses Apple's AirDrop, which only works with Apple devices, and Android uses QuickShare, which works with Android and Windows devices. The solution I found that is compatible with both is an app called LocalSend. LocalSend is an open-source cross-platform file sharing app that can share files quickly and easily between two devices on the same local network. It works much like AirDrop or QuickShare. First, ensure LocalSend is open and ready to receive on the receiving device. Then on the sending device, share a file via LocalSend, select the device to send it to, and done. To set up LocalSend on a Mac, you can download the LocalSend app from the App Store. I then set up in the app settings for LocalSend to open at startup as well as start hidden, so it's always ready to receive files from my phone. For making it easier to send files from my Mac, I've set up LocalSend as a sharing app. Do this by going to System Settings, Login Items and Extensions, Sharing, and ensure LocalSend is enabled. Now when I right-click on a file in Finder, for example, and select Share, LocalSend is now an option. Alternatively, you can drag a file into the open LocalSend app. To set up LocalSend on an Android phone, download LocalSend from the Google Play Store. It's automatically added to the Share to Apps list on Android. However, I have pinned it to the top so it can be selected more quickly. Note that since there is not a way to keep LocalSend open in the background on Android, when receiving files on Android, you first need to open the app. I can also use LocalSend to share text between my MacBook and phone. For example, to go from my Android phone to MacBook, select the text I'd like to copy on my phone, tap the paste icon at the bottom left, tap Share, and then tap LocalSend. Then, on my MacBook, assuming LocalSend is already running in the background, a screen with the sent text is shown. Click Copy to copy it to my MacBook's clipboard. To go the other way, copy the text I want to copy on my MacBook, open LocalSend, click Send, then click Paste, ensure LocalSend is open on my Android phone, and select my Android phone. Then tap Copy on my phone to copy it to my Android phone's clipboard. For tasks, I use a task manager app called TickTick. This app is available as an app for Android in the Google Play Store, as well as for Mac in the Mac App Store. This has become my go-to to-do list task app for its great support of recurring tasks, reminders, and on Android, the ability to have a shortcut to create a new task in quick settings. And it importantly syncs across my MacBook laptop and Pixel phone. Another option for tasks is Google Tasks. This is the default tasks app for Android. It's available in the Google Play Store and integrates well with the Google Assistant and Gemini. For Mac, there is not a native app, but there is a website for Google Tasks which can be installed to your MacBook as a web app. For my calendar, I use the default Google Calendar app on my Android phone. On my MacBook, I use Notion Calendar, which is a free app that syncs with Google Calendar. I prefer Notion Calendar over using Google Calendar's web app, as Notion Calendar is a native app on Mac. Notion Calendar is a visually well-designed app, and it ties in nicely with macOS, with a menu bar widget that lets you quickly preview upcoming events, as well as sending desktop notifications of upcoming events. For notes, I use a free app that works on both Android and Mac called SimpleNote. I like Simple Note because, as the name would suggest, it is a simple note-taking app for notes. No fancy features, just simple text notes. Simple Note has a native app for both Android as well as Mac, and the apps sync your notes across your devices. For text messaging, there are two main methods available for texting from your MacBook as an Android user. Google has an official web app for Google Messages, which works well and can be installed as a web app on your MacBook. The web app syncs with your Android phone and lets you send SMS, MMS, as well as RCS messages from your Android phone via your laptop. And the web app can also send you desktop notifications as long as the web app is open. The second method and the option I use is a third-party messaging client called Beeper. Beeper is a free app that works as one app for several messaging platforms. I regularly use both Google Messages and WhatsApp for messaging, and having both of these messaging apps in one app on my MacBook is great. In addition to these messaging apps, Beeper also supports several others such as Instagram, Facebook Messenger, Signal, and more. Beeper runs as a native macOS app, has a well-designed user interface that blends in nicely with the macOS design style, and most importantly, sends me desktop notifications on my MacBook when I receive new text messages. And since Beeper is a native Mac app, it can be set up to start when you start macOS, ensuring it's always running in the background to ensure you receive text message notifications on time. Now, more advanced features like changing group chat names and seeing typing indicators are the main things I notice Beeper does not support. I find Beeper works as a companion app for the official apps which I have installed on my Android phone, and covers nearly everything I need to do with messaging on my Mac, which is usually just reading and replying to text messages. For photos, I use Google Photos. Google Photos is the default photo management app for my Google Pixel phone, as well as many other Android phones, and its key feature is that it automatically backs up your photos and videos to your Google account. These backed up photos and videos can then be accessed via the Google Photos website, which you can install as a web app on a Mac via a web browser. So, when I need to search through my photos or download an entire photo album to my MacBook, I use the Google Photos web app. The web app on Mac includes a lot of the features you'd find in the Android app. You can create and share albums, edit photos, as well as search for photos. You can also set up your web browser to sync between your MacBook and Android phone. Now, the key here is to not use Safari, as it cannot sync with Android, as there is no Safari for Android app. But basically, all other major browsers do support syncing between Android and Mac. I use the Brave web browser, which supports syncing bookmarks, passwords, history, open tabs, and more. Other browsers like Google Chrome, Firefox, and Arc also generally support this. So select one of these and set it up to sync. Starting with Android 14, Android phones can be used as a USB webcam. Thus, my Google Pixel phone, when plugged in via USB cable to my MacBook, can be used as a webcam in any Mac app, such as FaceTime or Google Meet, letting me benefit from the high quality of the Pixel's camera in video calls on my Mac. It's pretty easy to set up as well. To use it, plug in your Android phone via a USB cable. Then on the Android phone, find the Android USB notification. It probably says something like charging this device via USB. Select it and change your USB connection to webcam. It's also possible to switch which camera on the Android phone is being used. Do this by going to the webcam notification on the phone to open the webcam preview. From here, you can change if the front or back camera is used, as well as the camera zoom level. Another way I use my Android phone with my MacBook is sharing my mobile data when I'm on the go. I can do this one of two ways, via Wi-Fi hotspot or via USB. For a Wi-Fi hotspot, there's a little setup needed the first time. On your Android phone, go to Settings, then go to Hotspot Settings, and make note of the Wi-Fi network password and name. Then turn on the hotspot. On the MacBook, connect to that Wi-Fi network and enter the password. Now, once you've done this setup once, your MacBook will remember and auto-connect to the network going forward. So now that I have this set up, the next time I need to use my phone's hotspot, just go to Quick Settings on my phone, tap Hotspot to turn it on, and my MacBook should automatically connect. I can also share my phone's data via a USB cable. To do this, go into the Settings app on the phone, find Hotspot and Tethering, and enable USB Tethering. Now on my Mac, since this is a cabled connection, it doesn't show up under Wi-Fi. But if I go into System Settings and then Network, I see that my Mac is currently connected to the Network Pixel 7. The advantage of a USB tethering connection versus a Wi-Fi hotspot is it's probably more reliable, as it is a hardwired connection, and it charges your phone while sharing data. With this video, I think I've shown it is possible to use an Android phone with a MacBook, and with the right apps and settings, make these two products work quite well together. I'm also glad there are apps out there that try to make this possible, letting users like me more freedom in choosing my own mix of hardware. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like this video and consider subscribing for more content like this. Thanks for watching. Until next time.